What the heck is that? What is a cove bit? It is a router bit that basically makes a cove, okay, on the corner of a board, okay? So this, I've already routed this one. This is board number one, the face of board number one. I've already done my cove bit here. We're going to use a router table to do that, and I'm going to walk you through that. And then Brian is actually going to route his board instead of me routing mine, since I've already done mine. So let's come on over to the router table. We should have hearing protection for this. This is Larry the Cable Guy doing a demo here in Berthoud High School. Get her done!
Yeah, it's Halloween.
Yeah, happy Halloween.
Where's all your guys' outfits?
Mine's in my backpack.
Come on, guys!
Let's go! Get over here! Let's go! You guys need to be over here so you can see what he's doing. Let's go! Not way over there. Not way over there. Get over here and stand around the router.
Now, there may be... This may not be set up. Okay, so you may have to set it up yourself. And in this cabinet, we have the wrenches for the collet. Okay, there's two wrenches here. Basically, underneath here, there is a wing nut on the router itself. You loosen up the wing nut, guys, and you lower this down by turning the router motor, okay? If you can't see what I'm doing, you better get a little closer and look, because you're gonna have to do this, okay? So to take that out, I basically take the two wrenches, bring it down low enough to where you can get on the nuts on the arbor, put the bottom one on the on that bottom nut, and then the top one goes on the top nut, and you turn that top nut counterclockwise to loosen it. Okay? And it probably works best if you squeeze these together, if you can set them up so that you can squeeze them together. Okay? Alright, so that's already tight. All of the router bits that you need are in this cabinet. Okay? And the one that we're going to be using later is a OG bit, and it looks something like that. That's a Roman OG. Okay, and we'll use that for the decorative edge on the outside of the clock. Okay, now you want the cove bit. How do you set the height of the cove bit? You want the cove bit to cut about halfway through the thickness of the material. So, how much is halfway through the thickness of the material, Tyler Williamson? How thick is the material?
The material of what?
This stock. What's the thickness?
Three quarter.
What's half of three quarter?
37.5.
Are you Tyler?
37.5.
No. What's half of 3/4 of an inch? Give me a break. Double the denominator. 3/8. 3/8 of an inch. Now, where did you hear 3/8 of an inch before?
For the
what?
Yeah.
Backside of board number two, we go down 3/8, right? Cove bit, we go down 3/8, right? You got it? Halfway through the material. Okay, now, we got this set up. This has a guide bearing in the center. Okay, so basically, this is going to give you the guide bearing. Once it touches this inside ring, that's going to basically gauge how far this goes in. So it automatically does that for you. You're not freehanding this, okay? Now, the bit turns clockwise, if you're looking at the top. So how do you want to move the wood? You want to move it opposite, so that would be counterclockwise. So all you do is hold your board down flat, keep your fingers away from the center of the circle. The on-off button is right here. And by the way, when you're changing bits, you should unplug the machine, okay? Got it plugged, and you can plug that right, unplug it right here. Okay? And then it won't come on for you. That way, because this thing does spin at about 27,000 RPMs. Okay, so you turn it on. Make counterclockwise circles. Try to go in just a little bit at a time, just like we did with the fluted bit on the back side.
That was clockwise.
No, I was going counterclockwise.
No, you were going the other way.
This is...
Yeah, you were going clockwise.
I was going clockwise. Okay, so you want to go counterclockwise.
He already cut it, so that's why it didn't matter.
So, here's Brian, and you'll tell... You'll tell by the feel. If you're going the wrong way, it's going to want to jerk it out of your hand. Okay? I had a student last year, wasn't holding on to this very tight, and it basically went flying. Luckily, his hands were safe, but, you know, make sure you keep this thing down flat on
the
tail.
You can see on the fence right there where people haven't paid attention to what they're doing.
And it broke off. Now, if this is really rough inside here, you should probably sand that a little bit ahead of time. This one, we could have done that, but we'll go ahead and do this. Okay, I'm going to do one little pass. Guys, stop talking. Can you guys not talk when I'm doing demos? Please. Okay, thank you. When you're going around here, I'm gonna do one pass, and I'm gonna try to just kind of skim the edge a little bit. And if you go too slow, what does it do? Burns the wood. You got to move fairly rapidly on this, okay? But not too fast. You just basically have to feel how the bit is cutting, and that will kind of gauge how fast you go, and you'll get a feel for it when you do it. Nobody say anything about me having a ring on.
I don't really worry about the ring too much on this thing.
Okay, you can see that I did not go all the way in. Because if you try to go in all the way in one pass, it's going to be taking so much material out, it's going to grab. And it's going to yank it out of your hands. So go a little bit at a time. And you saw how rapidly I was going there, didn't you? I was going pretty fast. Okay, I'm going to turn it over to Brad.
Not Brad.
I'm
Brian.
Turning it over to Brian. Brad's going to watch over here.
Watch your finger when that's going.
My. You scared me. Okay, pretty good job. He was having a little trouble staying in the circle. He was kind of going in a triangle pattern. But in the end, it was fine. Okay, And then when you, if you're going to pull that thing out of there before, while it's still turning, that's okay. Do not reach in like this, though. Okay, grab it from the outside, lift it straight up. Okay, let's go back over to my table. I hate leaving.
You need to move. I got plenty of muscle on my legs.
Whoa, what? Okay. This is a little bit of final preparation before we glue. Okay. Number 11 says sand with 120, 150, and I would add 220 on that also. Okay.
Let's go through the spectrum.
And it says face board and second board. Now, the reason we do that is when we glue this together, once it's glued, we're not going to be able to sand this face right here, okay, because, you know, you can't sand inside there and get all the way to the edge. So you do that before you glue it together right here, okay? And also, you're also not going to be able to sand this inside ring on the face board, again, because then you'd be scratching the, you know, number two board because you'd be going across the grain with it, okay? So, I've got... I've got a couple big wooden dowels up here that will help you for sanding on that inside ring. Okay, so I'm starting off with 120. And I'm wrapping this around there. And depending on how you wrap it will depend on how you the direction of the circle. Okay, if you go backwards, it's going to take that edge and rip it. So you want the edge that's laying down to be going that way. And you basically just go through here, guys. And you want to have this ready for finish. You want to have this part ready for finish. So it needs to be really, really sanded well. Okay, I've already pretty much done mine. And then you go down to 150 and then finally 220.
Did anybody know where the sled was? Did you ask them if they saw the sled?
No.
What?
There's a sled?
There was a sled for the planer over by the miter saw table. It looks similar to that image right there, and it's just disappeared. It's a piece of wood with an L-shaped piece of wood on it. And then you could put a smaller piece of wood on the sled and run it through the planer.
Now, the one that I made didn't have an L.
I thought it had an L.
No, it just had... to have a piece.
Okay,
to the
it's gone. Unless it's like that big, huge one that's back there.
That's it.
That big, huge one?
Yeah.
Because I know there was
that's
another one.
That's the one I made last year.
I don't have any more.
Okay, on this one, guys.
It'll be a scavenger.
I would make yourself a sanding block. Okay. I would make yourself just a little sanding block to keep in your locker because you're going to need this when after you cut it, you're going to have a lot of straight edges. Okay, now, anybody know what this is for?
Sommerfeld knows.
I've shown you guys. You just don't remember.
Over in the cabinet, I have some bench dogs right here underneath the.
What are they called again?
Bench dogs.
Dogs? Like
E-O-G? Bench dogs.
Woof.
Okay. And what you do with a bench? You want to put a piece of scrap wood in here so you don't mess up your clock. So. Grab me a little scrap piece. Just a little piece.
I always wonder what those holes in the table are for.
That's what they're for.
Yeah.
That's why you're in construction too.
Okay. This side, guys, since it's got a nice flat surface, that's not going to probably dent the wood, but this one over here will. Okay, and that way you can clamp that secure, and then you can go through and sand the face of that second board. And if you use a sanding block, you're going to get a nice flat surface. It's got to be flat because we got to glue that together.
Now, do they need to sand all the way where all the pencil marks are gone?
You know, I don't usually do that. It depends on your wood, on how well, if you glued the wood, if it's got any gaps. Probably would be a good idea to do this whole surface. You definitely want to get, but you know, basically where that sits, we want to make sure that part is finished sanded in the inside.
Not so much, but this side, definitely.
This side and this side. Now that cove I can kind of sand a little bit after I get it unclamped, but to get inside there, just do this, guys. Take your sandpaper, fold it in half, and kind of sand in there a little bit too. Get that finished up. But keep that corner crisp. Okay, what's that mean? Keep that corner crisp.
Keep it sharp.
Keep it sharp. Keep those corners sharp. We don't want them to get all rounded off and deformed.
Real sharp.
Okay, questions? I'm not going to show you guys gluing. We'll do that next time, okay? All right?
Get her done.
Get her done.